The other thing that we, of course, have to do is check if the user presses the correct button and then keep score. So I mentioned keeping score. Let's make a variable to keep track of the score. So I'm going to click go to variables, initialize a new variable called score. And I'm going to go to the math block and initialize our score to 0, which makes sense. When the recycle button is clicked, what we want to do is check, is this a recyclable object? If it is, let's increase the score by 1. If it's not, let's subtract 1 from the score. Now, how do we tell which of these is recyclable? What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new list and copy and paste the items that are recyclable. I'm going to go to variables. I'm going to initialize a new one. Let's move this up a little bit so we can see it. I'm going to call this recyclables. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this, make a list, and then just get rid of the ones that are not recyclable. So apple, banana peel, plastic bag is not recyclable. Plate is not recyclable, a smartphone is not. So let's make sure we've got the right ones. And I'm going to put them all up the top because what I'm going to end up doing is removing the extra items in my list. And I can do that by going to the blue cog, and I want to remove from the bottom. So if you notice, they disappear in the list above. Now I've got my recyclables. So let's see if we can code this when recycle button click. We want to test when they click, is the image a recyclable, meaning is the object in this list? So we can say if, and I'm going to either add or subtract from the score. So I'm going to use an if then else. And then I will go to the lists panel and I will pull out a isInList and the list, and I spelled recyclables wrong, so I'm going to fix that. Note that you can grab a get and a set both from the initialize as well as going back over here to variables, and you can grab a get and a set. So depending upon where it is on your screen, sometimes it's easier to do it here. So we're going to say is the thing that we're looking for, which is going to be the image picture, in the recyclables list. And so I'm going to go over here to object and grab a light colored object picture. So let's look again at what this block does. So is the object picture, which is the thing, is it in the list global recyclables? So for instance, is the cardboard box in recyclables? Is it, if it is, then we're going to add 1 to our score. Now it's a little interesting how you do that. So what we're going to do is grab a set, and if we click on the drop down, we're going to grab score. And what we need to do is basically say take the current score, whatever score is now. When we start the game, it's going to be 0, and add 1 to it. So we're going to grab a math block and a plus. Get the score as it is now and add a 1 to it. Again, what this block does is it sets the score to what score currently is and adds 1 to it. And then in the case where it's incorrect, it's not in the list, we're going to set it to and grab a minus. And what we can do is duplicate that and duplicate that and subtract a 1. Let's test this out. So let me click recycle for the plate. And nothing is happening. Why could that be? So what I've realized is that I've changed the score variable, but I haven't changed the score label in the app. So that's 0 in the app. the variable is storage kind of behind the scenes, and the score component that's displaying it is the thing that's visible and viewable by the user. What I'm going to do is go over to my score and find the setScore.txt block, and that's what I have to actually set within the block. So I'm going to put it below the if then else, and I'm going to set the score.txt to whatever the value of my score variable is. So let's try that again. So if I say recycle, so I get 1 point for that. I don't want to recycle that, but I'll try it. So I lost a point. I do want to recycle, gained a point. So it does appear that, oh, here's a banana peel. So yes, it did decrease. So that appears to be working.